Hello everyone, this is Ronald Schafer, and I'm live streaming through OBS into YouTube, and this is going to be day 21, and I'm going to do something a little different today. Yesterday was my 20th painting, and what I did was I called this Hops, and so what I did today was I kind of resketched the same concept art that I had done, and I revised it, and so I'm going to title today's Hops 2. And let's check the stream. Stream is going good. All right. So again, same size canvas, same technique. I just pretty much taped down some transfer film and print out the drawing I did on the computer, and I just take a number 2 pencil and I just go right onto it. And so today's is going to be a little bit different. I'm going, instead of like a landscape, I'm going vertical, and again, some easy tape just to be able to remove those two. And I'm also thinking I wanted to simplify what I did yesterday, so I actually eliminated 2 colors. Not sure if that'll speed things up or not. Let's see, that's all it is. Stick that to the side, you don't need that anymore. And then this is the new sketch, and from there that'll be my guide so that I can apply my acrylic paints. So again, it's yesterday, this is going to be today. Again, welcome to series 4, this is painting 2. I can just put that underneath. So these are the 2 colors I chose to get rid of. I'm not going to use the King's Gold or the bright yellow in the background. So those are now gone. And my background today will be Sunny Day. So let's get started. It's just a little standard cheap little brush. Sponge. First thing I like to do is go along the edge. Make sure you can see that. Okay. So that's what I'm really doing here. These are gallery wrap, so, you know, I want to make these presentable if these don't get framed. Find this down the side. Get in there, get that corner too. Set that down for a second, get you some more of that sunny day in there. You don't need a terrible lot of paint on the side just to make it presentable. Thinner the better, quicker it dries. Get that corner. So. Okay, this whole entire 4 edges are now painted. Need to let them dry. I'm going to try to hold this and still kind of work on a little painting here. I'll fill in today's background. Going to just be a sunny day. I felt yesterday's painting, again, was the first concept, and I felt like it was a little bit busy. So I have a couple, couple choices I made, eliminating some of the excess colors. And gotta wait for that dry before I can really angle this and show you, in case you're not having a good time seeing it. Until that dries, I gotta keep holding it. Yeah, I'm not applying this too thick. I want this to dry as quickly as possible. That also allows me to place, palm or hand while I'm painting in the hops or the stems or the leaves. If you were doing oil paint, you'd have to really rest your hand, arm, etc. somewhere else, because that's going to stay wet for a lot longer. There are methods to, get that oil paint to cure faster. There's things you can mix in with your paint. I don't think I have any with me right this moment. I don't do a terrible amount of oil. I have a lot of friends in the that do that for a living, a lot of oil paint, and they're amazing at it. I just always felt comfortable with acrylic. Maybe because I'm impatient. Who isn't? Edges are almost dry. Let's see how this looks. Okay. Let's see how this is looking over here. Almost dry. There we go. Bottom looks dry. Top is almost dry. See, we're getting there. You can get a little bit closer. There you go. So you can see it a little bit better. So. Again, just using a cheap little sponge. Little sponge brush. I think I picked those up at the dollar store. Got a whole pack of them for a buck. How can you go wrong? I'm not doing anything mission critical here. Now, if you need precision brushes, you know to go to a professional art supply store. Or you can maybe follow my link on the eBay. Maybe you can find some stuff there. Or if you want me to find some things for you, let me know. All right. Let's see if I can set this down for a minute. Now I'm gonna entirely, with just this sponge brush, apply the whole entire yellow background all the way up to the edges of this drawing. And what I end up doing is just using that tip corner to kind of use it as a real fine detail brush. See if I can get in there and show you. again, it doesn't have to be perfect. I'll be able to, I'm applying my colors later, I'll be able to kind of go over any gaps or any of that white canvas that still may be showing. So even if I go a little bit over these lines that I have down, I'll still be fine. Close enough. And you can do left-handed, you can do right-handed, it's up to you. I might do a little bit more of the right hand just to stay out of view of the camera. Let's move that. You know what? Let me get this up here now so I can lock this down soon. Now yesterday, you see me doing something a little bit different. Since the edges are dry now, I can actually get in here . See how that looks. There we go. Yeah, whatever's comfortable with you. Go. You get right in there. Work the brush. Okay, slowly starts taking shape. If I get there, here we go. Again, this doesn't have to be perfect. As close as you feel comfortable. If you have any excess paint, you can pull that out like this. If you're looking for a certain texture, you want it to be smooth, then smooth it out. If you want it to be bumpy, make everything bumpy. There we go. There we go. That half is done. Get a little bit more of this sunny day in there. So yesterday's video was about 2 hours long. Hoping I can beat that time today. Looking for a little bit more efficiency out of this. You know, it's one of those things. I did it once. Let's see. You know, what am I going to do to make this better? Let's put this up here. Let's just put it up on there. Let's get in here. And I'm just applying a light background. Nothing too crazy. Work with your shapes. a nice simple background. Work that brush in there. All your shapes. Yeah, it's okay if I paint over my lines. It's all right. I'll be able to correct that. This background's lighter, so it's fine. See any spots you want to get rid of that white? Now's the time to do it. Alright. So we only got one more step after this. That's good there. Got a little spot right here. Got a little spot right there. So I'm going to be painting a little bit into my line on purpose. That way I don't have any white popping through later. Go. There we go. Again, a little bit of a comparison. Let's see if you can see that. There you go. I had three different color backgrounds. Today, one. Figure let's simple this process. Let's simplify it. So. Okay, color one is down. So I went from the background, now I'm going to go to my leaves up top. My leaves, just like yesterday, so I got the wrong colors here. Here we go, had them out of order. Okay. So I'm going to use sea green and Victorian green. See, that's these two colors right here. I'm also going to change up how I apply these today, a little bit different technique. So Victorian green is going to be more of the main part of the leaf, and the sea green to be more toward like the vein, the structure of the leaf, and the edges. go. Two of the three leaves done. Now on to the sea green. What I'm going to do today is different. Instead of like a dry rub, we'll call it, I'm going to use a little bit of blending gel. That way I can get these on there smooth. So preload onto the brush. I'm only going to need a couple drops. Get all of those outlines in. I'll even add a drop right in. We're going to go on to the stems. English ivy. Right here. English ivy and Christmas green. I'm going to put those side by side, and I'm going to try to pick it up with the brush and apply once. There we go, both colors on there. See how this works out. I'm going to go this way. Pretty close. Blend that in. Go. Do that again. Show you. Right in the middle. Third time. Yeah. Do this part of the stem. Now we're going to go on to the hops, and we still have the same colors, pear and kiwi. Thinking I'm going to reverse the colors today to make this pop a little more. So this will be the base of the fruit, and this will be more of the edges, the kiwi. You can clean out your brush if you need to. Go, we're getting there. Oh my goodness, there it is. When did I do that? Just a couple drops. All you need to do to outlines. Just a couple drops. Black will go a long way. Just gonna pat this brush into the general area, clean it up after. Mixed in on the mustache is going to be a pure bronze. Go. go. Thank you for watching. This is Hops 2. That is Hops 1. And let's see how I did with time today. So yesterday's stream was about 2 hours, and this is about an hour and 15 minutes. So it's a little bit faster the second time around. So again, hope you enjoy. I'll see you tomorrow.